The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 11 through 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 25th of February, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Translation: I am the strength of the strong, devoid of passion and desire. I am sex life, which is not contrary to religious principles, O Lord of the Bharatas, Arjuna.
Next shloka.
All states of being, be they of goodness, passion, or ignorance, are manifested by my energy. I am, in one sense, everything, but I am independent. I am not under the modes of this material nature.
Balam balavatam chaham kamarava vibhajitam. Dharma virudhya bhuteshu kamasmi bharadarsana. Krishna is explaining everything, how he can become Krishna conscious 24 hours. The one process is recommended by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, pinadapi sunetena tarorapi sahishnuna amayina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. Kirtaniya sadahari. Always chanting the glories of the Lord. Manmana, satatam kirtayantam vaam. Krishna also says in the Bible, satatam kirtayantam vaam jatantascha diyavrata namasantascha maam bhaktya nitya jittu upasate. These are the mahatmas, symptoms of mahatma. They are always engaged in chanting the holy name. Satatam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also recommends. Kirtaniya sadahari. This is life. Human life is meant for this purpose. Kirtaniya sadahari. We require something to eat because we have got this body. So minimizing the bodily enjoyment. Bodily enjoyment means or necessities. When you use bodily necessities in excessive proportion, that is called kama. Otherwise, to satisfy the bodily necessities, that is not kama. Therefore, Krishna says, kamasmi bharatarsava dharma viruddhya bhuteshu. Dharma aviruddhya. Their religion, religion means regulation. Dharmanta sakshat bhagavat pranita. Everything has got a regulation, just like in our ordinary life, we get license. Even a man is keeping a wine shop, that is not a good thing. But he must take license, regulation. The whole shastra means regulation. Shastra. The word shastra has come from sasdhatu. Sasdhatu means ruling, controlling. From sasdhatu, the shasan has come, government ruling. And shastra has come, and shastra has come. Shastra means weapon, just like sword. It is called shastra, or guns. And shastra also. Shastra is a regulative principle, the book of law. You cannot violate the book of laws. Jashastra vidhimu sijja vartate kama karata na sukham sahabhagnati. You must keep yourself in regulative principles according to the shastra. So, here Krishna says, dharma aviruddhya kama. In the shastra, it is stated that jiva jivasya jivanam. Every living entity is living by eating another living entity. That is nature. Ahastani sahastanam. Shastra says in the Bhagavad. So those who have got no hands, they are food for the animal with hands. Those who are eating animals, they are also animals. Even human being, in the form of human being, eating animal. So, one human being means with hands. Sahastanam. Hasta means hand, and sa means whip. And the animals, ahastanam, ahastani, they have no hand, they have got only legs, four legs. So ahastani sahastanam, the with hands animal, those who are meat eating, they are animals, but with hands. That is the difference. Here is an animal, just like cows, goats, lambs, they are animals. And dogs, there are dog eaters also. There is the word sapacha. Sapacha means dog eaters. Jajjibhagranamatabham. Ahavato sapachopi kariyam. Jajjibhagranamatabham. Even a person coming from the family of dog eaters, there are dog eaters still. So, if he chants Hare Krishna Mahamantra, he becomes glorious. Ahavato sapachopi kariyan jajjibhagre namatubham. Chandal, they are called chandalas. Chandalopi dijasrashta hari bhakti parayana. Even if a chandal, chandal means the dog eaters. So these animal eaters, they are also animal this time. Animal with two hands. Ahastani sahastanam. Apadani chatuspadam. Apadani means those who have no legs, like plants, trees, the grass, they have no legs, they are standing. They have got legs, but they have no moving power. They are called padapa. Padapa means they have got legs for eating. We are eating with mouth, they are eating with legs. So everything analytical studies there in the Shastra. Very minor. Sensation power, who has got the fish, they have got very good sensation power. 2 miles away, they get sensation, there is enemy, somebody is coming to eat me. These are all described in the Bhagavad. The frogs, they can become in samadhi, situated in samadhi for many, many years. So these things are not very great things, to have samadhi, to have yogic principle. Even in the animals, you can will find. Yet I read long, long ago that in the coal mine, while they were digging coal, one frog came out from the coal and jumped over and died. That means the frog was buried within the lump of coal for many, many thousands of years. And he was keeping samadhi. Kumbhak jog, they know. So these are not very extraordinary things. Because after all, living entities eternal, then that die, na hannate hannamane sarire. If by some process he lives for some time more, that is not very wonderful thing. The wonderful thing is how to stop this birth and death, that is wonderful. Not that I am living, say, for 50 years or 100 years, another man is living for 300 years, and that is not very wonderful. So, there is regulative principle in the Shastra, as I was explaining. So we must follow the way. If we want to make our life perfect, we must follow the regulative principle. That a good citizen means, what is a good citizen? Good citizen who follows the laws of the state. He is good citizen. Good citizenship means strictly following the laws of the God. Similarly, first class human being means who follows the laws of God. Yes. He's first class. And those who are simply violating the laws of God, they are third class, fourth class, tenth class. And it will be explained a few verses after that. Then, namana duskitinam murha prabadnante naradhama. Those who are simply violating the laws of God, they are called duskritina, miscreants. Such class of men. There are so many classes of men. Krishna is mentioning some of them. Namana duskritina mura. The duskritina, those who are simply violating the laws of God, they are called duskritina. So, such person cannot come to Krishna consciousness, God consciousness. Though one must follow the rules and regulations, Shastra. Shastra means which is giving you regulative life. In regulative life, sex life is Krishna. That is regulative principle. And even with your wife, you cannot have sex life unless it is meant for progeny, for producing children. Krishna consciousness, not caste and love. That is dharma abhiruddha. That is not against religious principle. That is very nice. Just like to produce brahmachari. Brahmachari, where from the brahmachari comes? It comes from the grihastha life. Unless one marries, how he can beget children who become brahmachari? So, if you produce brahmachari, then you can produce hundreds of brahmachari. That is allowed. But don't produce cats and dogs. That is dharma avruddha. Krishna says, I am there. Everything is there. Krishna is everything. Even in sexual intercourse, there is Krishna. But how? Dharma avruddha. Not against the laws of Shastra. In the Shastra it is said that you will have sex life after the menstrual period. Sex life you have. But when your wife becomes pregnant, no more sex life. No more sex life. This is the injunction of the Shastra. You cannot have sex life for producing illegitimate son. That is described in the, that is called Varna Sankar. One who produces illegitimate children, the world becomes full of varna sankar, unwanted children, and thus the whole world becomes hell. This is stated in the Bhagavad. Now, it is a fact everyone knows that so many children, especially in the Western country, I have seen, a girl is not married, but he has got child. What is that? That is varna sankar. So varna sankar increases, the world becomes hellish. Why so much trouble now? Because, don't mind, it is according to Shastra, the whole population is varna sankar. Therefore, there is no regulative principle. If you follow regulative principle, there is no problem. And this regulative principle is Krishna's song, dharmanta sat sat bhagavatta nitam. He is giving, he is saying, dharma viruddhya kamasmi bhuteshu bharatara sava. So there is Krishna consciousness even in begetting children, provided you follow. So everything can be employed. Just like I was explaining to George, just now he came, that actually there is nothing material. Everything is spiritual. As Krishna is explaining from the very beginning, bhumi, apa, anala, vayu, kham, mana, buddhi, prakriti me bhinna astadha. Prakriti, my nature. Nature, I have already explained, just like nature of fire. How do you understand the nature? By heat and light. That is the nature. Whereby there is fire, parvato bhannivhan, dhuma, the example is given, I have seen in Nainital, there is fire, there is smoke. So that smoke means there is fire. That is a symptom. You cannot separate smoke from fire. That is not possible. Smoke is nature. Similarly, nature and the source from which, just like fire, it is coming, the smoke, you cannot separate. Similarly, if bhumi, apa, anala, vayu, khang, this material nature is coming from Krishna, how you can separate it from Krishna? It is also Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. One who does not see bhumi immediately remembers that this is Krishna's nature. He remembers immediately Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. Even by seeing land, so devotee sees like that. Oh, this land is so nice. Why not construct a nice temple for Krishna? This is Krishna conscious vision. Oh, there are so many skyscrapers. Why not construct a nice skyscraper temple of Krishna? That is Krishna. As soon as you become Krishna conscious, you become spiritual. Just like as soon as there is fire, immediately you become hot, warm. You touch the iron rod in the fire, it becomes warm, warmer, and then it becomes red hot, and when it is red hot, it is no more iron rod, it is fire. You touch everywhere, the same iron rod will burn. Similarly, if you become fully Krishna conscious, there is nothing material. Your body is spiritual, your mind is spiritual, your soul is already spiritual, everything is spiritual. Sarvam khalu idam brahma. That is Krishna consciousness. So simply we have to bring Krishna in every activity. Krishna consciousness movement is that for that purpose. And there will be no problem. You bring Krishna. Jat karosi, jat juhosi, jat dadasi. Jat adnasi, asnasi. Jat tapasasi, kurusatat madhapanam. Krishna says, whatever you eat, just like we are eating prasadam. Huh? Others will see, they are eating dal bhat and they are calling prasadam. Because he has no Krishna consciousness. And one who has got Krishna consciousness, he eats the same dal bhat. It is not dal bhat. It is spiritualized. Because it is offered to Krishna. Krishna has eaten it. Krishna eats. Don't think that the things are there. Krishna has not eaten. No, Krishna has eaten. But Krishna's eating and your eating is different. If I give you something to eat, you'll finish the whole thing. But Krishna is purna. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva avasishyate. This is Vedic India. He can eat and he can live. Otherwise, is he speaking false? Patram puspam phalam toyam jumi bhaktya prajacchati tadaham bhakta bhujtam asnami prajatatmana. He eats. So, one friend belongs to the Arya Samaj. He asked me this question, that you are offering in the temple, but does Krishna eat? He certainly eats. Why not? No, things are there. How he eats? Why you are comparing your eating and Krishna eating the same? Abhijananti manga mudha manasim tanumasita. Param bhava abhijanan. These rascals, they do not know what Krishna. He thinks Krishna is like me. These rascals, they do not know what Krishna. Why? Manushanam sarasesu kaschid jatati siddhaye jatatam api siddhanam kaschid bhetimam tattva. He does not know. Krishna can be known by the mercy of Krishna. Bhaktamava vijanati javan jaschami tattva. If you want to know Krishna tattva in truth, then you have to go through this bhakti process, not by your speculative process. Krishna is not open to your sensual gratification. Nahaṁ prakāsa saravasu yoga māyā samābhṛtā. You cannot be revealed to anyone and everyone. Yoga māyā samābhṛtā is covered. Just like at night, we cannot see the sun. That doesn't mean the sun is not in the sky. This is foolishness. If somebody thinks, now we cannot see the sun, therefore sun is gone, dead. Normally, people used to think like that. What is that? Some people used to think that sun is dead. So, Krishna is everywhere. And sun is always there in the sky. Now it is, say, 8:30. So, the morning 8:30 is also there present. In America, it is 8:30. There you see sun. So, because at night in India, in Bombay, 8:30, we cannot see the sun. It does not mean the sun is finished. If you go to America and Los Angeles, you will see the sun. Similarly, Krishna is always present. Simply, you have to prepare your eyes to see Krishna. Therefore, Krishna says, that dharma viruddha bhuteshu kamasmi bharatarsava, who is following the strictly the regulative principle, even in sex life he can see Krishna, which is considered abominable. But even in sex life, if you are following the rules and regulations, you can see Krishna. Therefore, when such sons are begotten, they become devotees of Krishna. Therefore, according to Hindu principle, there is garbhadan sanskar, 10 kinds of sanskars, reformative measures. So, the sex life should be also open to the sanskar. It is a sanskar. Garbhadan sanskar. Garbhadan sanskar means when you are going to make your wife pregnant, there is sanskar, there is ceremony. And especially in the Brahmana family, if there is no garbhadan sanskar, he immediately becomes a shudra. This is the sastrinya. You must follow the sanskar. Sanskarat bhavedija, janmana jayate shudra. One who follows the sanskaras, then he becomes purified. This is called dharma abhiruddha, not against the religious principle. So, if we do not follow the principles, then we are animals, that's all. That is the difference between animal and man. If you do not follow the regulative principles enjoined in the sastras, the sastra vidhimusthijya, vartate kamaka, kamacha, na sukham savapnati, because we do not follow the shastric injunction. Therefore, we are thinking that population is increasing, let us use contraceptive method. The so-called contraceptive method is there because we are having sex life against religion. Against religion. But if you have sex life in pursuance of the religious principle, you don't require. Because to become father and mother is not restricted. But to become father and mother of cats and dogs is restricted. To become father and mother is not restricted. That is nature. You become father of 100 children, but don't produce cats and dogs. Then there will be dharma viruddha, there will be unwanted population, problems, fight, no peace, no tranquility, everything, all. It will be hell. So because people are producing children against the just principle, therefore the whole world is full of varnasankar and there is no peace. So if you follow the principles of Bhagavad Gita, then automatically there will be peace. Because every children, every boy, every girl will be sober, Krishna conscious, and therefore Shastra prohibits pita anasasyat. One should not become father. Janani na sasyat, one should not become mother. Guru na sasyat, one should not become guru. One in this way. There. Why? Namo chayedya samupeta mrittum. If you cannot stop the course of birth and death of your children, then don't become a father. This is called religious consciousness. Remain without children. That is called dharmic life. If you can stop the birth and death of your children, birth and death means because the real soul, the real life is within the body and is transmigrating. Transmigrating from one body to another, that is called death. And when it comes out from another body, that is called birth. So every parent desires welfare of his children, of their children. So, this is the greatest welfare, that this child has come in my home. He has become my son. This is the last time, no more birth and death. He will be educated in this. That is father's responsibility. Not that meat eating and getting fat. However fat he may be, he will die. He cannot stop. He's there. Simply by making him fat like elephant. Therefore it is said, dharma viruddha. Don't beget children if you have no responsibility. But they think that we will have sex life, but we shall avoid this responsibility, so they'll let us use contraceptive. This is greatest sinful law. Greatest sinful law. You are killing murderers. Now in the Western countries they are actually killing. They are made law. So if the society has become so awfully sinful, how they can expect peace and prosperity? That is not possible. That is not possible. Therefore, Namaga Duskitana Mura Prabhupada, that's sloka I will explain later on. Those who are leading sinful lives, simply sinful lives, Duskritina. Kriti means very meritorious, but Duskriti, that is opposite. It is not Sukriti. Su means for well-being, and Duskriti means for creating disturbances. There are many brains nowadays. They know how to use the brain, but Duskriti no. Therefore, a godless society, there is so much restlessness in the society, because the Duskritina are working. Now in their place, Sukritina must be brought. Chatidvita bhajante maam, sukriti naam, then there will be peace and prosperity. Thank you very much.